Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class I will be discussing India, USA and China. Now this topic is important from interview preparation point of view. In this topic I will be discussing about what should be India's response to the altered equation, to the proposed altered equation between United States of America and China. How should India be, or you can put it another way, like how should India be responding to the changed equation between United States of America and China, the proposed change. First of all, we need to understand what is the proposed change. Proposed change. And then we need to understand India's response. India's response, and in India's response we need to understand what has been the old policy of India and what is going to be the or should be the new policy of India with respect to these two superpowers. One is United States of America and the other being China. Now proposed change between United States of America and China. Now China and United States of America, they have been conducting their diplomacy in a way by which they were not instigating each other at a phenomenal level, or they were just doing it to a level that was not crossing the threshold level. Both were conducting their diplomacy in the realm of trade, in the realm of climatic change, in the realm of development, in the realm of fighting terrorism, in a way that they were not acting in a way that antagonizes each other. And this was the reason that we have not seen any major altercation, any major iteration, any major and substantive dispute between China and Russia till now to a very existential level. Of late, what we are witnessing, or what is the proposed change? Now with the election of Donald Trump as the President of the United States of America, America would be trying to alter this relationship between USA and China. Now why this change will take place? Why this change will fructify? This will fructify because Donald Trump is a strong believer of anti-Chinaism. Now what is this anti-Chinaism? Anti-Chinaism means that Donald Trump believes that it's the faulty economic policies of China that has caused lot of trade damages, lot of financial and economic damages to United States of America. United States of America is also against the expansionist policies of China. United States of America under Donald Trump wants to assert the loosening position of being the number one power in the world. Donald Trump wants to assert itself over China. Donald Trump wants to hegemonize China. Donald Trump wants to base its entire trade, economic, foreign policies in a way that goes against China. Donald Trump is against two things. Firstly, he is against terrorism. And in terrorism, he is against Islamic terrorism. And secondly, he is against China. The way the Chinese products, the way the Chinese way of conducting economy has wreaked havoc with the United States of America's economic policies or economic setup. So is cheez ko wo change karna chahta hai Donald Trump. So the proposed change kya hone wala hai? Proposed change mein United States of America and China aapas mein kafi zyada conflict mein aane wale hain for the next few years till Donald Trump will be the president of United States of America. And he has already begun to pass the messages of conflict by overturning by rapprochement with Russia. रशिया के साथ दोस्ती करना शुरू कर दिया है ताकि रशियन चाइना आपस में दोस्ती इनका बरकरार ना रहे, इसको इनको तोड़ना है. And secondly, United States of America has also begun to question the integrity of China. Donald Trump has questioned the consensus of United States of America on China's one China policy. He is questioning the consensus of USA. He wants to trade with China for having good trade treaties with China. He wanted to have discounts in the realm of trade from China, and only that he will be ready to accept one China policy. So basically, these kind of changes that are taking place in the diplomacy, they directly go in establishing a situation of confrontation between United States of America and China. So basically, this class is more about what should be India's response to this proposed change, because this is a very substantive change. The old scenario, India had followed the policy of de-hyphenation. So first of all, we need to understand what is meant by de-hyphenation. Hyphenation means this. You're just adding in a hyphen and you're treating USA and China as if they're one country. So India in the past has followed the policy of de-hyphenation, that it was indulging in foreign affairs with the respective country in a dichotomized manner. Now, what is meant by in a dichotomized manner? It means India was not conducting its foreign policy with the United States of America in a way by getting influenced from China, or it was not conducting its affair with China by getting influenced from the United States of America. The foreign policy with both the countries was conducted by India independently. So the keyword here is independently. There was no influence from either of the powers. So India's independence for conducting foreign policy with both the countries is bound to undergo a change under the proposed change. What is this proposed change? The conflict, the ensuing conflict that would be taking place in USA, between USA and China. So how should India conduct its foreign policy so that this de-hyphenation may sustain? Now this de-hyphenation can sustain only and only if India will resort to non-alignment movement, to non-aligned ideology. Now, what was that non-aligned ideology? That India will not be aligning with any of the ideological realms or the ideological houses or the ideological bases. India will be conducting its foreign policy independently. India will not be interfering in the foreign relationship of other countries. So India need to act in a way that is more idealistic. So in order to address this real politic situation, the foreign policy should be conducted in a way that is idealistic. Now, what is idealistic way of conducting foreign policy? Believing in non-interfering in other countries, believing in respecting the sovereignty of the countries, respecting the human rights, respecting the welfare of the humanity. So this is the way how India should be conducting its foreign policy under the proposed changed situation. Now, if India will be joining either of the blocs, the bloc of USA or China, it will be hurting its long-term interests. Long-term interests of developing other country. So this is all for the class. Now, the question that can be critically analyzed, India's response to the proposed change in the USA and China relationship under the rule of under the leadership of Donald Trump. How should India be acting to preserve its interests vis-a-vis USA and China? So this is the question that can be asked. Now, if you want to read more, you can visit brainyias.com. If you want to read Brainy map on this, again, you can visit brainyias.com. Now, if you want to buy the video classes package on civil services preparation, you can visit brainyias.com or you can WhatsApp me at 84594000000. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice night.